You know, Bergdis got it, but, you know, Anthony spelt it right. You know what? Ally McBeal is one of my favourite, all-time favourite TV shows. And it's something I wouldn't normally have watched. Hey, look, Sakura Blossom's back. She's just been in timeout. Sakura Blossom is actually Faith, my daughter Faith. It's her birthday on Saturday. She's going to be 12. And it's my other son's birthday on Monday. So we've got a weekend of it this weekend. We're going to have some fun. We've got the fair in Corby at the moment, so we'll probably be going to the fair as well. Hello, Christian from Grantham.
Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now, let's get cracking.
That didn't work. Let's try that again.
Let's give it up big time. Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now, let's get cracking.
That's better. That's better. Now, I don't need these on anymore, so I was just listening to the Vangelis music. Obviously, we lost Vangelis today, and you all know my feelings for films like Blade Runner, that I just don't think much of the film at all. But the music is amazing, and obviously, out of the two tracks I could have picked, which are high up there on the Vangelis discography, is either Blade Runner or Chariots of Fire. So I poked Chariots of Fire today. If I get copyright striked, oh well, that's that. Hello, wait a minute, someone just popped in that I was wanting to say, oh look, Faith's happy now. First time live streaming. I'm struggling tonight, Todd, I'm telling you. I'm struggling tonight because I've already been hitting the rum. But I wanted to say hello to, and it keeps going, D8 Hole. Me and D8 Hole, we're on the way to get into Ultra Friends on Pokemon Go. I can't believe you're level 50 and I'm level 40, but I've got loads and loads of XP all in the bank because I need to catch 200 Pokemon in a day. And I just haven't got time to do that at the moment. So, but we'll get there. We'll get there. But yeah, bless her. Old Faith, you're getting so excited, aren't you? So I'm picking them up tomorrow and then I drop them off on Sunday. And then that's the last time I see the kiddies for a month, because next Friday, me and Mrs. Wilderwayne are heading off to Heathrow Airport. And on Saturday, we'll be in America. So looking forward to that. Hi, Wayne from sunny Arizona, 99. As a matter of fact, I saw Diabolik on here as well. Is it uncanny that I put Ally McBeal as the countdown guest today when obviously you're in Boston and that show was based there? But it's a great show. If you've never seen Ally McBeal, I used to think it was one of these, I used to call them chick flicks. I used to think it was like a chick flick, but I was so wrong. And after I watched the first series, I was hooked. I actually prefer that to things like Friends. And for me, it's on par with Big Bang Theory. I thought it was so funny. Absolutely love that show. And what am I drinking tonight? Look, I've released the Kraken. I'm on the Kraken tonight. I did have the bourbon. I had the bourbon yesterday. Wednesday? Tuesday. Tuesday was the bourbon, wasn't it? I was doing the Arduino on yesterday. And that hit me for six, so this Kraken's probably going to hit me for six as well. Last night's Patreon stream, we had a little bit of a hiccup, but we got there in the end and we got a motor driver to work. So now, you don't know what I'm building, some of the Patreons do, but everything's in place for programming, Arduino boards and everything for the build that I've got coming up. And again, a lot of Patreons have already guessed what it is. But tonight, I thought we'll have a retro night tonight, and that's why I've got a selection of some of the retro gizmos that I've got here. And I've also got something to show you tomorrow on the channel. Why can't I find my words tonight? Tomorrow on the channel, I've got the Lamborghini Miura. I built it today. What an amazing build. It looks great, and that's going to be up tomorrow morning. But later on today, I'm going to show you the Star Wars Starship Collection. There will be a video coming out for that because I am really impressed with that. And I want to do the video a bit more professional than I normally do. So I'm holding off filming it because I've got one of these photographic boxes coming. So I can have it in a nice background rather than you just see all my pens and equipment here. And talking of equipment, because we won't be talking about models much tonight, I want to mention a company. And they are called Top Notch Models, and I put a link down there. And saying that, I've put a link down there, but I want to move that link. How can I move that link? Because you can't. Oh dear. It won't let me move it. Oh, there we go. Nope. Ah, that's better. Now you can see the full address. Now, Top Notch Models is a friend of the family. I've been having problems doing primers. When I do primers on my kit models, I always use spray can now. I did buy the Vallejo grey primer, and I've got a gloss black. But you know what? It lasts about 3 minutes, if that, perhaps 4 minutes, in an airbrush before drying out. I've tried Airflow Improver. I've tried thinning it. It's the same thing. It just, I don't think primers are made that much for airbrush, or so I thought. And then, you've probably heard of this, Mr. Hobby, Mr. Surface Primer. Now this, staying by, is pretty amazing. I don't know if you've seen this, but this is a lacquer-based primer. And believe me, if you open this lid up, it's going to fumigate the whole of this workshop. It's pretty strong stuff. But I gave it a quick go on my airbrush, and I can't believe how nice this primer goes. And it feels a lot better than my acrylic primer does as well. So Top Notch Models normally do masks and stuff like that, but they have got a range for Mr. Hobby on there as well. So check out that website and see what they've got. But I'm going to be using some of his equipment when I'm building my... I almost said what it was then, when I'm building my next model. That was lucky. That's very lucky. Now, I did have something to show you tonight, but Dave Howe, I'm going to do that next on Tuesday, not tonight, because I haven't actually even downloaded the video yet, and I've just picked up your email. Dave Howe from Tyrell Models. God, we've got a right Blade Runner theme coming on tonight, haven't we? Which, again, I'm trying to... I can't move... I can't move it. Can I hide? Let me hide that Twitch overlay. There we go. So Dave Howe from Tyrell Models, if you remember, is doing the workstation. And a lot of people have put their names down to actually get first notification when that workstation becomes available. Well, he's actually sent me a video of the prototype. And I haven't downloaded it and I haven't embedded it in anything. So I want to do that for Tuesday so you can see exactly what the new workstation is going to look like. I'm getting rid of this one. And I will be using the new one when it comes because we've been designing it together and it's looking really, really good. So when that comes, it will be coming. Evangelis is an awesome composer. He was up there with my John Williams, my Jerry Goldsmith, my James Horner, my Alan Silvestri. I'm telling you, Evangelis was excellent. But yeah, we lost him today, unfortunately. What's my Pokemon main? World of Wayne. Will's Workshop. World of Wayne. If you send me an email, I'll send you my code. I'll give you my code now and you can see it. I'm not moaning at you. No, you're not. I'm just pretending, Faith. Hang on. I don't got a Pokemon. Bless. Right. I'm just bringing up my Pokemon code for you. Hello, Rick. How's it going over in the US? I can't wait to get over there. Although saying that, we had a lot of thunderstorms here last night. So, oh, bless. Faith's texting me at the moment. Bless her. I can't wait to see him, but I am going to miss him. I'm going to miss him awfully when I'm away, I have to say. Right, friends, add friend. There you go. There is my trainer code. So, I'll hold that on the screen for a few. You can go back on demand and you'll be able to put that in. So, that's my trainer code. And, I'll happily send you gifts every day. It's now turned into a Pokemon Go stream. What's a Pokemon? Sounds rude. Really, David? Don't know what Pokemon is and Pikachu? I know far too much about Pokemon than I should. But believe me, Pokemon for me is nothing compared to Mrs. World of Wayne. She's taken it to obsession, I'm telling you. Hi, Julian. How's it over in the West Country over there in Wales? I'm sure she's going to thank you, Kim. I think she's on chat at the moment, so she is looking at all the messages. I'm not going to see if I win a quiz tonight again at 9 o'clock. £300 prize tonight. If it's film night quiz, really. God, I wish I was there, Flashman. You could email me questions and I'll give you the answers. Although that is strictly cheating. It's not strictly cheating. It is cheating. need a baggage carrier. I haven't been home in 25 years. Really? I thought you were talking about the airport baggage carriers, Ed. Because you know what? Phil's just been through an airport. And apparently, our airports in this country at the moment, Heathrow, Manchester, Luton, are just having a living nightmare getting through security and baggages at the moment. Absolute nightmare. But we had to buy cases, Ed. because we didn't even own a case. I haven't been abroad for 12 years. And me and Mrs. Wilderwain have never been abroad together. So it's going to be a good little one for me. It's short for Pocket Monsters. Really? I didn't know that, Joseph. Pokemon, yeah. Wow, why did I never ever figure that out? Mrs. Wilderwain, are you watching this? Well, thank you, Joseph. I didn't even click. Wow. It's community day. Yeah, but I mean, tomorrow I go pick my kiddies up. So unless I leave ultra early and just sit around catching Pokemon, buy a few hotspots. I'll drop my link here. And hang on a second. Stand by. Because I don't know what it is. As Ian says, with Super Chat's great on YouTube. But unfortunately, they do take about 40% of anything that you donate to the channel. But Stream Elements do a way that you can do that, which doesn't do that. And I've put the link in chat there. I think sometimes it comes up by the bot as well. I think the bot automatically says it as well. But believe me, if you are donating anything to Faith for her birthday, God help us all. You didn't know that either, Mrs. Wilderwain. I'm considering myself schooled about Pokemon, which is cool. Yeah, your grandson's got nothing on Mrs. Wilderwain. I took her to London once, and every time I looked at her, all these beautiful sights around London, she weren't looking at. She was looking at the screen catching a Pokemon. So much so that she's pointing to locations where Pokemon are. She's pointing to fictional things. And I'm like, are you expecting me to see a Pokemon? Well, you know what? Most of my friends on my list, Joseph, are Japanese. It's mad. When it came to America, we shorted it to Pokemon. I wasn't aware of that, Joseph. Wow. It's all cool. So tonight, as I said, I've got a couple of things to show you. So I think the first thing I'm going to show you is, I'm not going to open these because I'm going to do that for the stream, but I want to give you an idea of size and what they look like. So, guten Abend, Karl Heinz. Wie geht es dir? So this is the Star Wars Starships and Vehicles collection. Now these are all die-cast metal with their own stands. And as you can see, they're ginormous. This is the size of my hand. It's a ginormous Millennium Falcon. And that's one of the first ships that we're going to see. Now when I do that, whoa, Ian. Wow. Thank you, Ian. I take it that's for Faith. She's gonna love that, mate. Thank you. Faith, I hope you're watching that. So as you can see, this is the first one, the Millennium Falcon, which looks absolutely brilliant. It's a lot bigger than I expected. I haven't opened it, but I do know that it's all metal. So not quite sure where I'm going to put it. And the second one that you get is a TIE bomber. No, it's not. It's Darth Vader's TIE ship. I thought it was a TIE bomber. Oh, I don't know. Looking like that. And again, size of my hand. If you hold your hand out in front of you, that's how big these things actually are. Because I know it's hard to see on stream how big these are. So these are the two that I'm going to be showing off. And then you've got magazines, which tell you all about the build. And then you've got your TIE Advanced prototype, looking like that. And then this magazine here, looking like that. But we'll go through that next week when I do the release of that. And I'll have a special link for that as well when it comes up. Robert, no. People might say yes, but no. You cannot put acrylic over lacquer. I've tried it. Or did I? I tried it the other way around. I put lacquer over acrylic. It doesn't work. I did it on the Orca, and it went bad. So unless it's completely dry, the lacquer is, then I'm guessing you can put acrylic over it. I wouldn't even attempt to put lacquer over acrylic. So, because remember, at the end of the day, lacquer and acrylic paints are exactly the same thing, except for the fact that the base of a lacquer paint is a solvent and the base of an acrylic paint is water. So once it's evaporated, they're just basically the same sort of paint. So, but yeah, not good. You got the, what doesn't work? Almost as big as my head. What's as big as my head? Joy, what are you going on about? What doesn't work? What's bigger than my head? Mrs. Wilderwain, you've just linked everyone to my YouTube channel. Is that right? Why are you linking people to my YouTube channel? I'm going to put that thing in one more time. Wait a minute, what did I just link? Yeah, there you go. We're all cool. You got Fallout 4 figures and a ship from Igamos. They are good. I have to say, with those figures, I mean, they only came this today. One second. Hello? What's that?
I was trying to link to your store, and if you click on that and then click store, you go to your store.
Oh, right. Or I'll type it in chat. Yeah. I'll put it in chat. One second. Okay. Alexa, stop. For my merch store, it's bit.ly/Wayne store. There you go. That's in chat as well. That's for all my merchandise and t-shirts and stuff like that. Release the Kraken. Have you noticed that I try and change this every day? I try. Whether it happens, I don't know. You decided not to send an email to a Gory by idea. It looks like it's not a good idea. Oh, dear. That's not good, Mapuck. The acrylic will crack and shrink. Yeah, no, definitely. Definitely. You've got to remember, because a solvent going on acrylic paint, as Troy said, it's just going to destroy it. You can't do it. You cannot do it. So, and I tried it. Believe me, it was fully tested on the Orca. I ended up having to sand it, believe it or not. So, see, Philip Spruverse had a vid on the Laurel and Hardy car and figures. He did. He's in the way of doing that. I'm hopefully going to see that. I don't know. He actually saw my stream where I was showing it for the first time. And I think it was from Infinity Statues or Infinite Statues, a German company. But it's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. As a matter of fact, I've been tagging Phil into all the Laurel and Hardy TikToks I can find at the moment. So, the Millennium Falcon. I was impressed because obviously I've seen the Star Trek collection from Eagle Moss and those figures, I mean, even though they're nice, they are quite small. These are big and in your face. I don't know about this channel. I like big on this channel. So the update, it's not happening this side of summer, Nathan. So at the moment, it's not happening this side of summer. So we might get luck in autumn. So we'll have to see. I haven't got pack 35 at the moment. Ian's got it though, Anthony, and he's it's been sent as well, and I have seen what's in it. But the rack is all soft plastic, is it? Oh god. And once we finish that, there can't be many more, is there? Is there like two packs left? Is that right? Don't know. You're watching from Sunny Jarrow. You're up north. Just got issue 18 in the Ecto 1 and all my electrics were apart from the blue lights. Don't know if it's a wire problem or a board. Don't know. Can't help you. Stream Elements. When you use Stream Elements, Pete, Stream Elements are the people that do these overlays here. So if anyone subscribes to the channel and you see the flash up on the screen and the name come up here, all that's managed by Stream Elements. But Stream Elements has bots. And those bots I can program to whatever I want, but I can't turn them off because otherwise you'll get generic messages from Stream Elements coming up. Unless you pay a premium for it or something. So that's what this Stream Elements keeps popping up. Now, it's meant to pop up every 8 to 10 minutes or something. But sometimes it just goes and has a complete, I don't know, meltdown. And you get the messages like you see here. You're having issues with Fan Home at the moment. They keep suspending my R2-D2 build. This kid said I'm not paid to... Really? That's crazy. I had the same thing, Wayne, with the Ferrari F40 a couple of days ago. So, hello, Robert. How's it going? You have two of the extra large Star Trek starships. They look the same size as those Star Wars. I think the extra large ones are. But every single one of these are that size, Robert. So if you can imagine all the Star Trek starships in extra large, you're pretty much there. But I don't know how many's in the collection. But you have got things like the Razor Crest. You've got, it goes right up to the TV series and Mandalorian and stuff. So it's going to be interesting to see what we get. Oh yeah, it's Fan Home that have done that, Roy, which is all cool. So I thought it'd be fun to show you some of my retro gear tonight, because I've taken them all off the retro shelf here. And the first thing I'm going to show you is this little bad boy. Now, Brian, I think it's Brian McDonald in New York. I think it was New York. Sent me a Transformer on a blister pack here. I think I've mentioned this story before. And this looks like this. It's a little bumblebee. As you can see, and what you do is you sort of pull out the wheels somehow, I don't know, like that. And then you pull the front out, and that turns into like legs. Stand by. There you go. One and two. And then you've got his little head here. And there we go. We've got Bumblebee as the robot. Now, I don't know how much these cost, but this was sent to me from New York and I've just broke it. One of his legs have fallen off. That's not good, because the next story is going to be even more shocking. I'll have to fix that. It's like Car Crash Tuesday. I don't know how much it costs to send, but because Brian didn't actually put the amount of money that this costs on the customs label, I got charged £89 customs for that. Now, I didn't know what was coming, so I had to pay that charge before they delivered it. And when it came, I'm like, £89. So, yeah. Now, apparently I can claim that back, but the amount of blue hoops that they ask you to go through to do that is a nightmare. I don't think I broke it. I think that just slots onto there. So, there we go. That's Bumblebee. Quite cool. I really thought that Ecto-1 would have been made out of metal, definitely. But as far as it isn't, you want a dino transformer. I mean, from back in the day, I remember transformers being ginormous things. It might have been because I'm small, but I'm sure they were big, really big things. But he slashed the resale by 100 bucks. What is that? Is that worth a lot of money, this one? This was already open, though. Or it might not have been open and this fell off. I just blue tacked it because I didn't want to put any sellotape on it. But I didn't even know that's worth. Don't break it too late. Oh, it's one of those nights. You had a big Megatron pistol transformer toy. Wow, I didn't know that, Troy. Well, I better go and fix that then and find the bit. I don't know where the bit fell off, to be honest with you. I'll find it after the stream. We'll see what happens. So that's my first thing. So the second thing, obviously, I'm not trying to kill vampires and stuff, but this was pretty much the follow-up to the Rubik Cube, and it was advertised as the next great puzzle from the Rubik Snake. But I think everybody makes the snake now. But this is the original one from the 80s, which come, in the ball. I've only got half the ball, so I can actually stand this up. So obviously you've got the Rubik's Cube, which I completed before stream, using a web page to help, because I can't complete. If you wanted to complete the Rubik's Cube in the 80s, you got the knife and took the thing apart, or you took all the stickers off and replaced them. But, you know, technology now, you can just program what the sides are and it'll program it for you. So, no problems, Faith, you take care. So, I don't know if you've ever played with one of these, and I haven't played with one for a long time. So, it fits in this by turning it into a ball. Now, the last time I did this was pretty much when I was a kid, but let's see if I can make the ball. So it's sort of like this. Stand by. Ah, it's like model making again. There you go. And then you go like this, like that. Think I'll end up breaking this one next as well. Okay, we're looking good. Yeah, get in there. Oops, there you go. One more, that way, 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 and that way. Whoops. I think we're there. Almost. Got to spin that one round. Oh, I put this one in the wrong way. There you go. The ball. I can still do it. So that, I haven't had that long. I got this about 4 years ago, but I didn't want a rebranded one. I wanted something from the 80s. That's why it's a little bit yellow. This used to be white, and the plastic has now turned yellow, as you see. Probably need some peroxide on that if I want to make that back to restored quality. And obviously put this on top. But I used to love this. It's ingenious, some of the things you can make from it. So that's that. This is my original first computer. This is the rubber-keyed ZX Spectrum. Now, with a ZX Spectrum, obviously, you connect it to the TV with an RF lead, so it went into the aerial socket. You plugged in, you didn't really use the mic socket, but you needed the earpiece to connect to a tape recorder. And in this little expansion slot here, the only expansion that I ever used in it was either a Kempston joystick, so I can control the thing, or what they call a multiface, so I can actually pause games and cheat and type poke numbers in. Obviously the power in here. But this was your rubber key spectrum. And what I like about this is that all the keys, none of the letters are rubbed off. And this is my one from the 80s, which I used all the time. See, they don't make them like these do they? Because, like, if you had that nowadays, those letters would be completely bold to say they're rubber. I bet you if you rubbed them long enough, they would come off. But still quite good condition. I think the only thing wrong with this is the cover here, this faceplate, can come off, as you can see. But it's still quite clean underneath. And then you've got, like, the rubber keyboard here underneath. I don't know if it still works. It should do, but I don't have any of the power accessories for it. But this is a piece of memorabilia for me because this is my first computer. David, this was actually a 16K, but my dad took it away and got it upgraded to a 48K. So this was the 48K, and then after this, you got the 48K Plus, which was slightly bigger, and you didn't have the rubber keys anymore. It had the tappy-tappy keys. So, that was my pride and joy. We're going to be talking about Gremlins, which I'm trying to nick from Lou, who's got an actual Gremlin, but I like my gizmo. Absolutely obsessed with Gremlins I was as a kid. And I'm going to get my joy when I go to Universal in a couple of weeks, because obviously the Hill Valley set was also the set for, what was it called? Kingston Falls or something like that in Gremlins. So got my little Gremlin on the shelf. And his partner in crime is Alf. If you remember Alf on my retro show. Some of these shows, I'm surprised they don't repeat them, because I've never seen Alf on repeat, which is pretty crazy. So that's that one. Someone sent me this Mr. Stay Puffed, looking like that. It's like a little dog toy, really. But that really should go with the Ecto one. And another one of my pride and joys, this was the original E.T., with the light up finger. Now, when I got this, I completely ripped it apart because it still had Christmas tree lights in the lights there, and his finger didn't work. So I replaced the LED in his finger. I replaced the Christmas tree lights because they were flasher lights. So basically his lights were blinking, one and two, and I didn't like that really. And look how the switch is put in, just with screws. Back in the 80s, that was, I'm telling you. So when you turn him on, as you can see, he glows up and his finger glows up. Ouch. Oh, I love that little guy. So that's my ET. And then some of my pride and joys. So you all remember the Tomytronics here. And this still works. This still works. So what I've done before stream is I've showed you some footage. This one was called Sky Attack. And you'd look through here. You'd need sunlight to go through the top here to actually play the game. And this is what the game looked like. Now, I remember being a shark game as well, but the only other one I got was this. I've lost the sticker off this one now. This was the same sort of thing, but this was 3D racing. And once again, this is what this looked like. They look so cheesy now, I'm telling you. Great game. Now, back in the day, they didn't have like an end level. Just games just got harder and harder and harder. And in the case of Tomytronics, you can't rage quit on these things. The only way to rage quit is to take the batteries out, because it wouldn't let you turn the game off unless you've completed and you've got to game over. I could press that off button as much as I wanted. It wouldn't turn off until the game's finished. But absolutely love that. But things have changed. Hi, Steve. How's it going? I'm sorry. I was off on one, having my little chat. The Kempston joystick. Yep. Gotta love the Kempston joystick. You love stuff. I mean, I'm obsessed with the 80s. It was a great era to be brought up in. See, the Spectrum Plus 2, that's when they got bought out by Amstrad, wasn't it? So and you had the cassette recorder next to it. I had the plus three after that, so I had the disc drive for it. So feeding the cat. You've still got a large Alf. Alf's on YouTube. Yeah, I mean, I don't know what the copyright situation on that is. But I got Mrs. Welder Wayne. I'm taking you all down a trip to memory. You had a ZX81, Mark? Oh my God, that was... Yeah. I mean, that only had like 1K of memory, didn't it? 1K of memory. That's like a sentence now in a Word document. You've been tempted with the Enterprise. I'm so sorry for people that have been tuning in for the Enterprise. I just haven't had time to do it. And when I get back from America, I'll redo my schedule to make sure we do that. Check out YouTube video on 40th anniversary update to the ZX Spectrum to make it work again. Front panel only attached with double-sided tape. Yeah, my one was. That's probably why the tape's gone on now. But from what I remember, Chris, this still works. And my plus three Spectrum I had, my brother's got that at the moment. I mean, that's the speaker there, look. It's a great little thing. But, yeah, can't beat the old ZX Spectrum. So anyway, I sent Mrs. Welder Wayne out today because I wanted to show you something else which I haven't actually had started up, but I wanted to get batteries for it. Now, unfortunately, this isn't the... let me just hide the message. This isn't the original. And the way I know it isn't the original, it's a big track. Because on the original, not only did you have to put D cells in the bottom, but you also had to put a 9-volt battery in this compartment here. On the new ones, you don't. There's no compartment here. This doesn't open. But Big Track was a programmable sort of like car. And what you do is you've got a keypad here. Let me show you this if you've never seen this before. And you could program it to go forwards, back, left and right, delay, fire its gun. And you've also got these other buttons here. I think out was one of them. That... Shut up. Where you could attach a trailer to it and the trailer would pick up and drop things off and stuff like that. So to program it, if I wanted to go forwards, it's by feet. So I could put up, one, and then go. And as you can see, it will start to go. If I wanted it to turn, I mean, let's put it on here and try that again. Whoa. I'm going to move my... Coke out the way. Gotta love a big track. Hang on a second. Right, so what we can do is then, if I can add, without clearing the memory, I can get it to turn. So it's like a clock. If I ask it to turn 15, it will turn 15 minutes. So it will turn 90 degrees. So theoretically, if this works, please work. Let's have a go. See? And then if I want it to fire its gun, I'll clear the memory and... It's going to fire 5 times. And you can program this as much as you want. So I used to have the whole thing going around my house, through corners and all of that. As long as the start point is stationary to you, you could get it to go everywhere. But that's my big track. And if you had one of them when you was a kid, you probably remember that sound. The doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Pride and joy. I'm telling you, pride and joy. Yeah, Gizmo's dead. I'll probably feed him or get him wet, see what happens. Name featured on the card at the end of every video. Oh, let's stream elements. Why am I even stream elements out? All classics like Alf, Ninja Master, available in Germany. Really? God, I've seen some of these things pop up on Forces TV, which is quite fun. But, wow, Big Track. You remember the Big Track? The Big Track was brilliant. I'm probably going to have a play with that. See, now, speak and spell the date hole. I wanted one of them for Christmas, but Santa never bought it for me, so I always wanted a speak and spell. I've got a list here of things that I do want still that I had as a kid, which I'd love to get back to put in the retro corner, and I'll show you what they are at the moment. Do you remember Merlin? It used to look like a phone. Don't think so. It's got a lot, yeah, it actually works, Robert, compared to the Spitfire. So, a couple of other things we've got. Now, this is a little bit of a cheat because this came out in the late 80s, 89, but I don't think we got it in the UK until the 90s, so this is more like a 90 thing. And that is, obviously, the original Game Boy. Now, I've only got one game for this, which is Tetris, but it still works. So, oops. And used to change the shade here depending on what light you're in, so you can make it go dark. Why would you have it like that? I don't know. Or light. And you've got the familiar. And then when you play it, it's a... Now I want Super Mario Land for this, so that's going to be the have to ROM to get. And obviously these just came on when I get them out, just these little cassettes here. I'll get Super Mario Land because I think out of all the games I played was Tetris and Super Mario Land. But it still works. I think the only problem with my one is that I occasionally have to just jiggle the batteries around to get it good contact, and I have cleaned the contacts, so God knows what's going on with it. But the fact that it actually turns on and still works is a godsend. So having a Game Boy, pretty good. You had Evil. Yeah, I used to love the Evil Knievel. The one on the red ramp, which used to roll up. That was brilliant. You hated Tetris and all the clones of it. Have we got spam tonight? Wow. Who's spamming? Oh, wow. We got, stop, wow. We're doing well tonight. The mods are good. I don't know what it is about my channel. I'm attracting them lately. And I haven't even talked about the P word tonight. So, hello, Faith. How's it going? Are you enjoying the stream? Watching Daddy play with all his toys? Where does he get those wonderful toys? So, I want to show you some of the things. Why am I, what? What? Oh, Tin Can Alley. Now, my brother had that for a Christmas, and that was operated by a light beam, from what I remember. I used to have laser tag as well back in the 80s, and that had a 100-meter range. Think about it. A laser going 100 meters to hit the target. I used to run around and enjoy that. It was great. So, the Lost in Actions. The Lost in Actions. These are the things that I'd really like to find or get hold of again. And it was interesting that I can't remember your name telling us about where the origins of Pokemon come. Apparently, Mrs. Wilder Wayne said she can't hear me speaking, so stand by, I'll say that again. There we go. You can hear me speaking now. Okay, so the first one was Master Challenge. I'm telling you, the rum tonight. So that book at the top had loads of general knowledge questions in, and what you'd do is you'd type the number of the question on the left pad, you'd put your multiple guess answer in, whether it's A, B, C, or D, click the answer button, and then the light would either be yes, you got it right, or no, you got it wrong. Simples, but I absolutely love the game. And then you could get upgrades for it, which would be a different book, and then you just slot that computer part into the new book so you can answer new questions. That's probably why I know so much about absolutely nothing. So the Master Challenge was good. The next one, head-to-head boxing. Now, me and my brothers used to play this all the time, and we used to really frap those buttons big time. I don't know if you remember that. It was basically two lights, and you had lights coming out from their hand to try and knock them down. That was quite a fun game. The one that I used to take to school all the time, and I believe this goes for quite a lot of money on eBay, which is the Game & Watch, the Mario Brothers. And this was the one where they're packing boxes. And you need to get the boxes off the conveyor belt before they fall off and stick them in the trucks there. I used to love these little fold-out games. And I think that's the only one I had. And I do believe Donkey Kong. They did Donkey Kong as well. But it wasn't open sideways. It opened vertically, that one. You probably remember this one, Astro Wars. Again, I used to have that as a kid. I'd like to see that again. And the other one, Puck Monster. Now, Puck Monster was the original name for Pac-Man. And you can see why they had to rename it Pac-Man. Because if you had Puck Monster on arcades, you can imagine what sort of graffiti that would be turned into. So, but again, that's a lost in the past, something that I'd like to get hold of eventually. So, thought I'd just take you for a little whistle-stop tour. Bring food in the car. We're in a van tomorrow, Faith. It's a van tomorrow. But I will bring you food and drink, if that's okay. You remember the Donkey Kong, do you? Oh, take care, Robert. You see you later, mate. you still have an original Game & Watch, really, Tony? Oh my god. I mean, I had that one, but obviously in school it was like swapping lunch. You'd swap your game so someone else could have a play of the game. I think I took the Tomytronics in, because you always, on the last day of term, they'd let you bring in whatever games you want. But you can get bored of those games quite quickly, which is quite fun. Astro Boys nearly got one a few weeks back. They wanted £140, Ian. Oh my god. Do you remember it though? It's a great game. They had a lander one as well. Same sort of thing, and it was the same sort of box design, but you had to land a lander straight up sort of thing. Pretty much like Elon Musk is doing with his SpaceX rockets at the moment. So, Eagle was starting to drop the ball on the quality of the kits. I've just received the Eleanor today, Robert, but I am expecting the Ecto one, and I'm expecting Titanic as well, but I am a little bit behind on Titanic. So I don't think realistically I'm going to be able to get on any of those builds until after I'm back from America. You had games in the UK you've never seen before, really? I thought they were like the staple of the 80s, Steve. Especially that Puck Monster game. I mean, I've just went on eBay beforehand, and there's quite a few of them in the eBay store. You still play Puck Monster? Wow. Astro Wars, my favourite Vectrex system, Mark. Wow. I didn't think people still had this stuff, you know. It's interesting because in Corby, we have a recycle centre where they go for house clearances, or they take things that people have bought to the dump when it's not something you want to chuck away, and they resell it on. And this week, they've actually got an original Kenner AT-AT in there. It hasn't got the door. That's it. Other than that, even the guns are there at the front. You know, those clear guns used to fall out. They're still there. And that auction's on Sunday. And I'm thinking, perhaps I should just have a look. But I'm not here. So, you do occasionally see one. Okay, Van. I will bring some food in the van, Faith. I promise. You still got Astro Wars, Wayne. I didn't think people still had this stuff. You know, when back in the, it must have been the 90s, there was a big boom in boot sales and all of this stuff. Even Star Wars figures ended up in boot sales in America. I suppose they call them, what do they call them in America? Yard sales? No, it wouldn't be yard sales because it's not in someone's yard. In Australia, we used to call it trash and treasure. I don't know what you Americans would call it. What do you call it where people take all their bric-a-brac to a massive venue and just basically sell from a pasting table or from the back of your car? Not just from your house. No idea. Well, you sent the idea to Agora anyway. And here is the answer to me. Hello, Marcus. Thank you for sharing the idea. I've passed this on. Thank you. Well, you've got to remember, Mapuck, that the customer service team will feed back to the actual people that are running the head office. So the customer service team are primarily there to deal with problems. But if they got solutions, then they will let them know. So give them time, because they will get back to you. The original electronic battleship had big clunky buttons. If you made a mistake with an input, you had to start again. Oh, God. Sounds like most of the games on the Spectrum. Do you remember you didn't get like a... You had games where... I think Sabrewolf was a good example. That if you died, there was no restart point. There was no like continue from where you left off. You had to go all the way back to the beginning. A lot of Game Boy games are like that as well. Gremlins, funny enough. Gremlins speak to mind. I used to have Gremlins on the Game Boy, and that was one of those games. Your English teacher confiscated and never got it back. I'd sue. Sue the school. Look, another one. Look, Craig, your one got taken away by a teacher. What is it with these teachers? Mrs. Wilder Wayne, is there a conspiracy amongst teachers? I need to know. What do you do with all your confiscated stuff? Now, you can tell us. We won't tell anyone, I promise. Do you give it back? Or does that go to the fund? You still got your original big track. I mean, you don't need that 9-volt battery anymore, Paul. But and the Game Boy Color. I think, do you remember, Paul, with the Game Boy, do you remember that you had to get add-ons for it? So obviously you couldn't play the Game Boy in the dark because you needed light on the screen. So you could have a Game Boy light on it. And you had a Game Boy case on it. Then you can have a Game Boy little camera, which was god-awful quality. And a little Game Boy printer. I mean, Nintendo knew what they were doing when they released this. But Who knows? But the thing is, obviously, these things are redundant now because we've all got smartphones. This is theoretically the first smartphone. I mean, who actually uses a smartphone now for phoning people? I'm just texting. I text. I very rarely speak on my phone. We're going to have to go and give the fish their last feed for the day. Take care, John. See you later, mate. You started the Spitfire up yesterday, and guess what? Total disaster, enough said. John, join the club. We are going to be the Spitfire Club. Mine was working, John. You saw that. But as soon as that lifter failed, everything just catastrophically went wrong from there. But there you go. Craig, I don't know if you heard the stream yesterday, but Phil said that he started getting stuff from Eagle Moss now. So I'm hoping things are going to get ironed out. So you might start getting stuff soon. GoBot toys. Why do I remember GoBot? Don't know. I never had one, but I do remember the name. Hashtag dismissed any further issues with Spitfire landing gear, even though it's still an issue for some. Really? Are they doing that? La la la, we're not listening. La la. Does anyone remember Magic Robot? No. What did Magic Robot do? I remember other games I had, electronic games, Simon. Do you remember that with the coloured things and you just had to, it's like a memory game, and you had to remember the sequence of the colours. I was a sucker for electrical games, I tell you. But then when the Spectrum came out, I was buying cassettes like no one's business. So I was playing the Manic Miner, Jet Set Willy, Sabrewulf, Underworld, Quasartron, Ranorama. These are just all my favourite games. Target Renegade, The Way of the Exploding Fist, Bruce Lee. Everyone's a Wally. Do you remember that series? And that was 3 weeks in paradise. Then the Dizzy games, Finders Keepers, Batman, RoboCop, the film tie-ins. Wow. Oh, reminiscing. It's probably because I'm getting near 50. I'm 50 next year, so I am reminiscing. I remember Mousetrap before it got toned down, Adrian. Rebound. That was the one with the elastic bands, wasn't it? And the puck. But I'd like to get an original Mousetrap, because the Mousetrap nowadays is nothing like that, is it? Do you remember Downfall as well? I used to like that game. You put the little bead at the top and you turn the thing, and it's different for the player on the other side, and it's the one to get the beads to the bottom first or something. The one Christmas I was so happy when I saw I had an Action Man. When I opened the box, it was empty. They told me it's an Action Man deserter. Oh, Mark, that's not good. Bless. My brother had an Action Man pursuiter. Action Man is the G.I. Joe equivalent in the UK. He had one of these parachute or pursuit towers. I think that's all I remember. And you could, he had the eagle-eyed one, so you flicked it and his eyes would move left and right. Dylan Kilgore, you've still got AT-AT, the original Kenner in a box. Wow. Wow. That's pretty impressive. You know what? Seeing that picture from the recycle centre of that AT-AT did make me think, I'd like to build that. I don't know why. It's just the size of it. It was imposing. It was great. It's a garage sale. Yeah, but do you still call it a garage sale? We call it garage over here. Do you still call it a garage sale, even though you're not in your garage? Because what we're doing is we're taking our car, filling it to the brim full of stuff, and going out to like a massive field where loads of other people are, and then selling stuff off a table. So it's not in front of your house, if you like. Swamp meets. Ah, flea market. I suppose so, yeah. You can pick up some right gems there. I remember seeing a lot of the old Kenner Star Wars figures at those things, Steve. Big time. So what I used to do was buy the Kenner figures, and chances are they wouldn't have the guns, but then I'd ask for the guns and the weapons separately and try and match them off. And I think in the end, when I had my Kenner figures, because I had so many, I think I had the set, but hardly any of them on cards. Even the Power of the Force figures with Yak Face and Anakin Skywalker and Han Solo in Carbonite. But what I'd do is I'd match off the weapon that they actually supposed to have. Then I'd put them in plastic bags and I had them all pinned to the wall. And then you know what I did with them? I gave them away. And that must have been about, Esther, when did we meet? 91? 92? It was about a year after we met. So 93. I gave away all my Star Wars figures in about 93. Can you still see the pain on my face? if I redo the Enterprise D, will it have his navigation light synced? So Icarus, I don't know if you've seen in the past, the way it's going to be, the beacon light's going to be doing this, and then the navigation lights, both sets, are going to be blinking opposite to the beacon light. So the ones at the back and the front are going to be synced, but it's going to be off sync to the beacon light, if that makes sense. So, I used to have a computer that played games from a floppy disk. The slot was in the side of the screen. That game I played was in green, and you had to work out how to get through rooms. I can't remember that, Scott. I remember the BBC Micro had one of the big 5 1/4 inch floppy drives. I used to have one of them as well. But again, I've mentioned it before. The only games I used to play on it were Daredevil Dennis and Elite, or Elite Dangerous as it's known now. Can't believe that game's still around. I know very well, Wayne, it'll take a year before there'll be any changes. I mean, yeah, I mean, especially if it's a production thing, a map up, because they'd have to get back to them. But you think about all the mistakes that we've had in past builds, like the Hasher. So many people are talking about on the Bismarck that third radar not spinning, but it's never been fixed. And it's only a case of watching channels where people have actually pointed it out. So that's why I'm trying to get in the habit now, if there's an error, telling you about that error. That's why I was so happy with the R2-D2, that it got fixed straight away. Because if I wouldn't have noticed that, either R2 would be going off the table, or the diagnostic wouldn't run properly. So I'm waiting for that to come. Normally, when I've ordered an extra part, it does come separately. I don't have to wait for the next delivery. So I'll get a delivery of just that issue on its own. You're currently playing with an R2-D2 Tamagotchis. Wow. You know what? I bought my kids a Tamagotchi years ago, and they really went up in price. There was a thing that everyone's doing it. But, you know, again, I'm surprised there's still a market for Tamagotchis when you've got smartphones. Because, like, playing Pokemon Go is like having a Tamagotchi. You've got a pet that you've got to feed and make it happy, and it helps you out if you make it happy. It doesn't die on you, though. You got the Rubik's Magic. Wow. No, you can't say that, Dylan. Gremlins 2 was amazing. And you know why it was amazing? Because it was taking the piss out of itself. That's why I loved it. Because you watch the first one, not knowing what you're getting into for the second one. Because I saw Gremlins 2 at the cinema. I was actually in Wolverhampton, I think, when I saw the Gremlins 2. And obviously the video release was different from the cinema release. So where they had that interruption with the Gremlins in the cinema, I believe Hulk Hogan came out and told the projector to put the film back on. But on the home video release, I think it was John Wayne, wasn't it? That they superimposed him. But I loved it. I love Gremlins too. You have all your old computers. Well, you know what? I should have bought my dad. My dad's got an Amstrad 512 original laptop. So this was a ginormous laptop. More like a suitcase. It had a little green screen on it. And it took 3.5 inch floppies. He's still got that. Don't think he's ever turned it on. I think it runs some version of Windows. God knows what. I don't think it was MS-DOS. It's probably the first ever version of Windows on it. No, I'd never kept my games consoles. I mean, I didn't have many. I say I didn't have many. And then I'm going to read out hundreds for you. I had the Mega Drive. I had the Dreamcast, I had a GameCube, I had a Wii, I had an Xbox, Xbox 360, Xbox One, and now I've got PlayStations, PlayStation 5. You always give it back at the end of half term, sure you do. Am I that far behind on chat again? Oh, I'm sorry. Hi, Helder. We're just having a little reminisce down the 80s here, Helder. That's what you've been missing. You'll have to watch the catch-up. Do teachers have their own? I reckon they do. I reckon there's a secret coven of teachers, like a witch's coven, where they get all their confiscated loot and compare it. And that's why there's secret eBay accounts. I couldn't get into He-Man, Adrian. Funny enough, though, the Kevin Smith He-Man, Revelations, I enjoyed on Netflix. You had a Grandstand BMX Buyer Flyer Laser Color game. I don't remember that. Ah, oh, the magnifying glass as well, yeah. You never had a big track. They're still available because they reissued them about a couple of years ago, Anthony. So you can still get them. That's where I got mine from. I got mine from like a Mankind, I think the shop was called, like a Hawkins Bazaar or Gadget Store. My brother's on here. Hello, Michael. Decided that one of the artwork companies need to release build Airwolf. Michael, how many people have said they want Airwolf released? There's loads. But you never know. Might come one day. If it does, I think that is a model that's going to need to have things moving on it. It can't be a static model, otherwise it's just basically a... it's just a helicopter. Mr. Stretch, I remember that. I broke my Mr. Stretch. It was full of corn flour or something. It was some horrible flour in it. So yeah, you could. There's only a limit to how much you could stretch it, and you can't bite it either. Yeah, I had a habit of chewing my toys like that. I was a biter. There's a fabled pit in Colville. I know Colville. That's where don't they do scuba diving there? Where loads of Star Wars figures are reputedly buried. Really? That's not far down the road from me. Ken, if you get any coordinates, I'm happy to meet up and we'll go hunting for them. You reckon the teachers have a raffle among themselves? We've started teacher conspiracies here. Stretch Armstrong. Can I ask a question of what got for birthday? You'll have to find out. It's only 2 days, Faith. You've got a couple of things here and there's some things on order for you. So, you'll have to see. Bless you. Have you heard that officially, Larry? Because I've heard that that's delayed as well. So, I don't know. Don't know. You find that Saturday. There you go, Mrs. Welder Wayne said as well. The lifter failed. As well, tried to come out of the bottom of the base. Yeah, that's what happened to me, John. And I don't know if it was the same as yours, but it looked like one of the contacts on the lifter had broke off. And that just started a calamity. Absolute calamity. Attic attack. Simon's still available today. God. Way of the exploding fist was amazing. Test my Ecto-1 electronics with the Ghost Modders mods. Pretty cool. On stage 70, looks like I'll be stuck there for a while. Ghost Modders mods. I haven't seen that, Dylan. I'll have to look at that. I did like Ian's little fix about just swamping the thing in grease. I actually did that. I swamped mine in grease, but I'm still getting the same noise. You get the chatter from the gears, and I think the main reason for that is because you're only sort of like pinning it down at the top. The gears aren't exactly screwed in, so they are free to do this, and that's what's making that absolute racket. I don't think all the grease in the world is going to stop that completely. Rock'em Sock'em Robots. Ah, yeah. And that brought rise to Real Steel with Hugh Jackman. I love that film. There was rumours of a sequel to that. But, never. Flea Market. So that's what we call Flea Market. You have a couple of toy robots that have suction cups on the bottom of them. Really? I think the only things I ever had suction cups was the Garfield you used to stick in your car. Oh, bless. I'll have a midlife crisis. I could buy myself a Harley, Ian, but, you know, the missus won't let me ride it. I'll only get around just looking at it if I was lucky. I'm having my midlife crisis. This is why I surround myself with all this retro stuff, Ian. I'm having my midlife crisis now. I guarantee, when I'm off in America, I'm going to be looking for retro stuff. I will be looking for retro stuff. I really want to look for a Flash Gordon Ajax 80s. I really want a Bobo, the owl from Clash of the Titans. I'm looking for one of them. So there you go. All 80s stuff still. You know what? I was watching The Young Ones today. How's that? Living in the 80s. Do you remember the old Rick Mayall, Adrian Emerson, Nigel Planer and Christopher Ryan series? I need to get myself an R2-D2 Tamagotchi. Are they available, are they? R2-D2 Tamagotchi. Oh my god. Are you serious? They are available. How much is that going to set me back? $21.99. You might have convinced me outside. Next time you see me, I'll be holding my stream going, hang on, hang on. R2 wants attention. Oh, bless. Oh, look, everyone's telling me they're called swap meets. I had no idea. Wayne, check your Instagram. Just sent a picture. Okay. Stand by. Paul Reynolds sent me a message. Oh, wow. Wow. Let me see if I can share this screen, Paul. There you go. Check that out. So you got Super Mario Land. Brilliant game. I've never played any of the other games, I have to say. I think Super Mario Land's probably the only game I would play. I was addicted to that. I love the music as well. BBC and Micro and Elite. That's where it's at. You know, I reckon that still holds up today, Anthony Oates, if I could play that. The amount of hours I spent on that probably rivaled the amount of hours I spent on World of Warcraft. You sold all... It kills you now, doesn't it? TK421, just thinking about it. A tenner. Falcon, Snowspeeder, Darth Tie Advance, X-Wings, and loads of figures. So all of my... I had the figures. I didn't have the ATAT. I had the Millennium Falcon, X-Wing, Speeder Bike, a B-Wing Fighter with the sort of like gyroscopic sort of cockpit. So when you turned it, the cockpit turned as well. Is that it? I think that's it, ship-wise. I had some of the off-camera ships. Do you remember the thing with two wheels that holds a couple of stormtroopers? But, yeah. You've still got an old Texas Instruments one as well. Why do you keep it though, Ian? Is it nostalgia? Because I bet you haven't played it or been on it, have you? Wayne is the baby of the family. Here we go. And he was extremely sporty. He had everything because his mum couldn't say no. Oh, I know a wife like that. I wasn't spoiled. I just wanted electronic stuff, and I liked electronic stuff. We really are getting the spam bots in tonight, aren't we? Well, there you go. With the youngest kid, the parents are just tired of whining. Yeah, that's it. You know, my mum, she'll tell you some stories. Apparently, I was so misbehaved in Australia, and I used to scream so much. Australia's got big gardens in some of their house. She'd lead me down the bottom of the garden. Bearing in mind that every single poisonous creature that ever roams the earth lives in Australia. She thought that was fine. I survived. I'm here today to tell the story. Is it gourmet? It's the same thing, Sheldon. They're exactly the same model. Exactly the same. Hi, Elder. You're over on YouTube now. I'm losing track. You're on Facebook and then you come over onto YouTube. Bless you. And there you let him have everything. She doesn't. Oh my God, look at the time. I'm sorry. I've been trapped in this 80s little bubble that I put myself into. But I hope you enjoyed this little look down the 80s lane. I've probably been chatting to myself, to be honest with you, just looking at all the comments that I've missed. I'm sorry if I did miss your comment. I didn't mean to. I've just been reminiscing and drinking rum and having a good time. So it's been a fun night. Tomorrow, we've got the Lamborghini Miura coming out. Mrs. World of Wayne's video is going to be on Saturday. And I'm hoping to get the Star Wars video out on Sunday. But it all depends about this weekend because we've got a busy weekend. Kid's birthday. So looking forward to that. But listen, thank you for joining me tonight. Take care.